And joining us via Skype to discuss this quickly is the CEO of Diaspora PR, Jermaine Sonwo-Olu. Thank you for joining us on the show. Now, US is appealing for the use of force, but Japan and Russia are saying that let's calm down, let's engage in more dialogue. What do you think is the way to go?
Well, thanks a lot for having me this morning. Well, I believe diplomatic option is always the best route to go. You're right by saying that China and also Russia are actually saying that we should actually relax when it comes to North Korea, but they're actually a very potent threat to international security, and to have such a nation having nuclear capabilities is actually a threat not just to the world, to South Korea, Japan, and also Guam and America as a whole. So we have to be very, very careful in how we deal with them. Diplomatic options are already the best, but I'm sure military options will not be taken off the table at this moment.
Yes, indeed. Well, some are saying that diplomacy may just be fantasy because, you know, it's still uncertain how the UN and countries like the US and Europe actually want to respond to this, you know, ballistic missile provocations coming from North Korea. It's no longer, well, now it is a global challenge that we have on our hands.
Yeah, it's absolutely a global challenge. We have some nuclear power nations such as Russia and China being allies of North Korea, and the others such as USA, UK and France being on the other side. This is what looks like the making of another world war, but let's hope it will never get to that level because Donald Trump has already promised to reply them with fire and with fury, and they are not backing down for any moment. The UN actually has to step up its efforts because they have to actually apply more sanctions, tougher sanctions that will actually affect North Korea. And we have to ask our question, what kind of sanctions are going to be very, very potent?
All right, since sanctions have not been effective in the past, that is why U.S. is pushing for this, really. But then it seems that the U.S.'s hands are kind of tied. It had an overwhelming nuclear arsenal, but then it has so many things to consider. First of its allies, Japan and South Korea, before taking action.
Yes, they have to consider the safety of South Korea and Japan. South Korea just recently launched their own test to just to prove, show of force that they are also capable of striking back too. But this is something that is very, very delicate situation because we see, you know, that the world powers who have nuclear powers are actually saying that right now we have to reconsider one, the Nuclear Proliferation Act of disarming all nations of nuclear abilities, because in the light of nations that are North Korea actually rising up to actually be a threat to the world, if they actually go ahead and launch their ballistic intercontinental ballistic missile, which can reach places like Ohio in America and also affect Guam, which is an American province, then that is going to spell a lot of trouble. China has to come in and step in very hard because China is the greatest trading partner and the greatest ally to North Korea, take away their trade abilities and also try and almost strangle the economy of North Korea to ensure that they are actually feeling the pain of the UN sanctions, to ensure that they don't actually keep on feeling they can be testing weapons at their own will. If not, it's going to lead to greater tensions in that region and uncertainty and instability in the world round over.
And there really is so much uncertainty. And China responding to Trump's policy of sanctions against countries that have trade dealings with North Korea. Some are already saying it's like, you know, cutting your nose to spite your face, because it's going to cost America some if it really goes the way of sanctions against countries like China, for example.
Well, yes, I believe the UN also and America making that suggestion. I've actually just seen, looked for a way to actually hurt North Korea and also their allies, China, because China is just staying back and not really doing anything. North Korea actually did that nuclear test in a day whereby China was actually organizing the BRICS nations, that's developing economies, a conference in China. So Russia was there, India, South Africa were all there, and to try and ensure that the world develops. But what we see North Korea is saying that we want to draw the world back to our 1970, 1960 time. type of nation. So what has to actually happen is that China has to actually be penalized too, because if they keep on supporting a threat to the nation, that means they themselves inadvertently is a threat. And you know that US and China, Donald Trump has actually said that they are trying to sue China because of the theft of intellectual property. So the relationship between China and America is a bit dicey. They are both world powers, but one is now supporting a rogue nuclear potential nuclear nation. So that's what we are seeing right now. And China has to own up, has to take responsibility, and have to sign on the side of peace rather than on the side of this warring rogue nation.
Yes, indeed. Jermaine Sanwo-Olu, Diaspora PR, thank you so much for your time and always responding to us. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.